The LenFi team have released V2 of their borrowing and lending protocol, and this is a big game changer. UI, UX, performance, and security upgrades all packed into this brand new upgrade, making borrowing and lending on the Cardano DeFi space so much easier and so much better compared to before. Let's get into it. This show is educational and it's informative. Crypto's the future, really it ain't. So first up, big congratulations to the LenFi team for getting to this point. They've been working hard on getting V2 out there, and I'm very impressed with it so far. And if this is your first time here on the channel, please consider giving me a thumbs up, click subscribe, click on that notification bell. I talk all things Cardano and I cover the ecosystem as much as possible. So this is the article that goes through all their changes, and I'll go through this quickly to get you up to date with everything that is new in V2. Now, they're bringing in this brand new pool market design, this isolated pool market design, and we'll go through that in a little bit as well, but also allows anyone to open up a lending pool and become a pool manager. This is really good for anyone that is creating a token in the Cardano ecosystem and wants to create the pool themselves. It allows you to put in that liquidity and people can borrow and lend against that asset in that managed pool. So it's really good. It creates that level of decentralization within the platform. And I thought this is a really cool feature that added in here, and it allows anyone that is creating these managed pools to stake the ADA to any stake pool out there in the Cardano ecosystem to continuously earn those rewards while that ADA is waiting to be lent out. So I thought that was a really cool feature. Furthermore, the pool manager is managed by NFT and can be traded as a commodity. So maybe in the future, if you're managing one of these pools and you don't want to participate in this anymore, you can put that up for sale and someone else can buy the managed rights to it, or maybe you can even fractionalize that NFT and then a community can take control of that as well. So there's lots of cool mechanics around this, and I love what the team have put in place. Now, the tokenized debt bonds isn't a new feature. They've had it on V1, but they've also integrated into their V2 of the protocol. You can see it here on their NFT bond market, where you can buy and trade your loan positions on this particular marketplace. So you can exit your loan quicker by trying to find someone that would potentially borrow against that loan. So it's a nice mechanism to make your loans a little bit more liquid. The new native multi-asset support is also a really good feature. It allows anyone to put up a pool that borrows or lends against any token and ADA. So that makes it a lot more diverse and more flexible for anyone in the ecosystem. The open liquidations is also an interesting feature in that it allows anyone to become a liquidator on the platform. So if you see that a loan is getting too risky in the ecosystem, you could potentially liquidate that loan and earn some of the collateral from it. They've got some documentation around this. So if you want to learn a little bit more about it, you can see this documentation. So they explain it here in simple terms. The liquidator repays the loan and receives part of the collateral to compensate debt plus fee. I will be doing some documentation and tutorials around this. So if anyone wants to become a liquidator, they can do so and earn some of the assets and fees for doing so. Now, governance has always been a critical role in the LenFi ecosystem, and V2 is going to be the same. So the V2 ecosystem will rely on the DAO to manage whitelisting, fee structures, empowering the community to shape the protocol's future. So it's good to see that the LenFi team are keeping up with that DAO structure and governance on the platform. Now, of course, with any borrowing and lending protocol or any protocol that runs on smart contracts, security is always key. And it's really good to see that the LenFi team went through not just one, but two audits through some really big Cardano ecosystem players, Anastasia Labs and TX Pipe, the creators of Aiken. So Aiken is powering all of the smart contracts for LenFi V2 as well. Now, a lot of things that came out of that audit were a lot of performance and UX improvements that were given to the team as well. And it's really good to see that some of those improvements were added into the final release of LenFi. And I'll show you that all in a moment. Now, one of the really big things I love about LenFi, and they've always pushed for open source, and the V2 version of the smart contracts are all open source, and you can get to them now already. You can see them here on their GitHub repo if you are wanting to learn how they've done it, how they've built it, and audit the smart contracts for yourself. You can do so. You can see exactly how it all works. They've also run a bug bounty, $20,000 for their bug bounty program. So if you're a capable smart contract developer and you want to poke some holes at this smart contract, go ahead. You can earn some of that $20,000 in rewards. Now, early in the video, I did mention isolated market pool design, and this is a really cool security feature in that potential smart contract breaches only impact individual pools rather than the entire protocol. So if someone does manage to compromise one of the pools, it's isolated just to that amount of TVL locked in that smart contract, which I think is a brilliant security design. Now, to make it easy for you guys, if you want to get into LenFi, there's lots of documentation. I did go through this as well. There's plenty of documentation on their website. It's a little bit technical at some points and aspects. There's a bit of code in here as well. But if you want to dig deep into how LenFi works, all the documentation is there. But I'll be creating tutorials and course material around this. So if you want to learn more about LenFi, you can do so. You can get to all of that at learncardano.io and then get your hands dirty in Cardano DeFi as well. So let's have a quick look at the platform itself. And since its launch yesterday, we can already see we're almost touching here at 3 million ADA in TVL on the platform. So we have all these pools here that have been created. We have a lot more pools than we did before, and users can borrow and lend against all these assets quite easily. Now, I do like the brand new pool design. It makes it so much easier to understand. The UI UX just makes sense. So here we can see NMaker and ADA pool. We can either deposit assets into this or borrow ADA against it. So if I click on IAG, for example, click on deposit, I can then choose how much I want to deposit into this pool. So let's say I have lots of IAG tokens. I don't know what to do with them. I can add them to this particular pool, click deposit, deposit my IAG tokens into this, and then earn some of the APR that's from it. So you can see here the current supply APR is at 4.38%. So that's quite a nice little return for supplying some IAG tokens on the platform. Now, on the flip side, if you did want to borrow some IAG, it's not too bad either. Maybe there's a governance thing coming up and you need some more IAG tokens to get your foot in the door to make a proposal vote. You can borrow that as well and make it all happen. And the interest on these loans aren't too high either. So it's quite a nice mechanism that they've all put in place to make this all happen. You also have the health factor ratings there as well. So I'm limited to the amount of ADA I have my wallet here, so I can't borrow that much IAG. So let's lower this down. There we go. So we can have a nice health factor rating here, so we know how much we can actually borrow. So the higher the health factor, the better. So here you can see where you can create your own pool. You can choose whatever token you want. So let's say it's milk tokens here. You can choose a collateral. In this case, I'll choose ADA as a collateral. The initial deposit, maybe it's just 2 milk because that's all I have. And then I can choose the stake pool that this ADA is going to be delegated to. So I can grab a pool ID from pooltool.io, such as that one there. And then in here, paste that in. And then there we go. So now this brand new pool here that I'm creating will have an initial supply of 2 milk ADA, collateral of ADA, and then have it all delegated to this stake pool here by stake pool ADAOZ. So love this, absolutely love what they've put together here. So here I'm going to go through the process of depositing some IAG to the platform in this existing pool. So we have a minimum deposit of 178. So I'll put in 200 IAG tokens. You can see it's worth around just under 60 ADA. So here I'll click on deposit. Everything looks good. Let's confirm that. And I just have to sign my transaction. And there we go. So now that is successfully submitted. And now I have provided some IAG tokens to the IAG ADA pool for anyone else to borrow within the ecosystem. Now that I've deposited some assets into the platform, I can see on the dashboard here all of the assets that I have. And here's my IAG tokens that I've just put in. I can manage my deposit here, I can withdraw, and I can also see some pool information around my deposit as well. If I had any loans out, I'll be able to see them here, and I can also see all of my transactions that I have within the platform as well. So a nice way to visually see and manage everything that I do on the platform. Now, if you have been using the old platform, you can still get to it. The link's up there, P2P market. So this is the older peer-to-peer market, borrowing and lending marketplace. You can see everything here still. There's still a lot of loans on the platform as well. So if you're used to this, if you have been using it, it is still there. You can still use it. But as you can see, the brand new version is a stark difference compared to the old, with a much simpler UI UX experience for borrowing and lending on Cardano. So once again, congratulations to the LenFi team for launching V2 of their protocol. I'll be playing around with this a lot more. You'll see a lot more tutorials, course materials, lots of blog posts about this, so that if you wanted to get into the LenFi ecosystem and learn about borrowing and lending on Cardano, you can do so. It's actually really easy. Just check out all the course material that I have so far on learncardano.io. There'll be a lot more coming up. But in the meantime, if you like this episode, if you like what LenFi are doing in the Cardano ecosystem, make sure you give me that thumbs up, click subscribe, click on that notification bell. Lots more Cardano related content coming right at you, and I'll see you in the next video. Yeah, gotta do it like that. You've been listening to the Learn Cardano podcast.